So the basic operations are things that you should already know, but I'm just going to go over the terminology that goes with those. We have addition. When you talk about addition, you're talking about, can maybe zoom in a little bit on that. You're talking about something like 20 plus 7 is 27. The answer to an addition problem is called a sum, and the two things that you're adding are add-ins. All right, so that's just the terminology that I want you to have be familiar with. And then we have subtraction. For subtraction, if you had 20 minus 7, remember you'd have to borrow and you'd make that 10. And 10 minus 7 is 3, you get 13. Remember the borrowing thing. And that's something that you should have coming in. So I'm not going to spend a lot of time on just the basic subtraction. The answer to a subtraction problem, though, is what I want to get to, and that is that it's called a difference. Now, this also has a name. You have a menuend, is what you're subtracting from, and you have a subtrahend that you're subtracting, and it makes a difference the order when you're talking about subtraction. But it doesn't make a difference when you're adding. That's why these are both called add-ins. There's no separate name. Whatever's on top or bottom doesn't matter. But it does matter when you're talking about subtraction. That's why we call them different things. So in addition, we could say 20 plus 7 equals 7 plus 20, right? Those two things can be flip-flop. That's the commutative property. But we can't do that. We can't say 20 minus 7 equals 7 minus 20. That, in fact, does not equal. We put the little slash through there. So we have to give them different names because it depends on whether they're first or second. For multiplication, we have something like 20 times 7, and that would be 140, and the answer to that would be a product. And multiplication is like addition in that it doesn't matter the order that you give it, and so both of these are called factors. And we could see again that 20 times 7 is equal to 7 times 20. So they have, doesn't matter which one comes first, so we don't give them separate names. And then we have division. And in division, I could write division number of different ways. I could say 20 divided by 7, but I'm going to do 20 divided by 7 like this, and I'm going to say 7 goes into 20 twice. Remember this process. If you don't, then you should go, you can Google it and work on that. So you get 6. 7 doesn't go into 6, so it's 2 with a remainder of 6. Now here, these all have names, so I want to give those. The answer is the quotient. What's left over is the remainder. What you're dividing into is the dividend. And what you were dividing by is the divisor. Now, when we talk about multiply and divide, I might have gone off there, sorry. When we talk about multiply and divide, we have all this terminology to know, but also there's different ways to write it. So we're used to writing multiplication with an X, but we could also say 20 times 7. That would be another way to write that. Or I could say 20 and I could put parentheses around it. If I don't put any operation in between those, I assume that means multiplication. So I could also write it that way. In fact, I could do 20 times 7. That means the same thing. As long as I don't have an operation between those two parentheses, it means to multiply those. I could even do this. Those all equal the same thing. And so we find that in algebra, we stop using the x as we go further into math because that suggests a variable, which we'll talk about more later, but we don't always want to use that x for multiplication. And for division, if I had the 20 divided by 7 like this, then this first number is the dividend. The dividend is what goes under when you're doing division like this. It also goes into your calculator from left to right, just like you read 20, then divided by then by the 7. And then 7 is the divisor. And how we like to write that when we're doing, as we go further into math, is like this. 20 over 7 also means division, and that is the dividend on top and the divisor on the bottom. Now I want to say one more thing on the end of this video is that our divisor can never be 0. So if I had 20 divided by 0, we can't do that. If you try it on your calculator, you'll get an error message. What we're going to say is that that's undefined. We cannot do it. So we don't say, oh, can't be done. We use the word, the term undefined. We can't divide by 0. On the other hand, if 0 is on the top, that's fine. That says 0 because this says 20 goes into 0 0 times. This says 0 goes into 20. Well, how many times would nothing go into something? It can't be done. It's undefined. So we can't have 0 as a divisor, but we can have 0 as a dividend. No matter what you have on top, if 0 is the divisor, it's always undefined. So I'm going to circle the terms here that I really want you to know that are the most important. I want you to know what a sum is, and I want you to know a difference. I want you to know product. And factors is a term that comes up enough that you should get familiar with that. I want you to know dividend and divisor and quotient and remainder. Remainder, we'll start using decimals as we go further. And the last thing I definitely want you to know is remember is what is undefined. That means when you divide by 0. Okay, that's it for the basic operations.